Hello dear students, in continuation of the poem The Tale of Custard the Dragon part 1, we had done the introduction, summary and first stanza of the poem. Now we will do second stanza onwards in this video. Now let's start the second stanza. Now the name of the little black kitten was Ink, and the little gray mouse, she called him Blink, and the little yellow dog was sharp as mustard, but the dragon was a coward and she called him Custard. Mustard, a yellow colored flower that is used as a spice also, that mustard. Coward, weakling. In this stanza, the poet explains the name of all the animals that are tamed by Belinda. He says that the name of black kitten is Ink, the name of gray mouse is Blink. The little yellow dog had yellow color and so she calls him Mustard. And the dragon that was a coward means was a weakling, was called Custard. So here in this stanza we got to know all the names of the pets. As Ink is the name of the kitten, gray mouse is called as Blink, and yellow dog is called as Mustard because of his yellow color, and the dragon called Custard. So their names we got to know. Literary devices we will do. Rhyme scheme is AABB because Ink, Blink rhymes, Mustard and Custard rhyme. Simile is used here as dog is compared to mustard. The little yellow dog was sharp as mustard. So simile is used here. Alliteration, simile you follow. Figure of speech where things are compared with the help of comparative words. Alliteration is also used here. Alliteration is a figure of speech where consonant sounds are repeated. Coward and she called him. So C consonant sound is repeated in coward and called. Anaphora is used here. What is anaphora? Repeated use of words at the start of two consecutive lines. Here, and the little gray and the little yellow. So, and the little, these three words are repeated in continuous two lines. Repetition, use of word little. Little word is repeated. Stanza third. Custard the dragon had big sharp teeth and spikes on top of him, and scales underneath, mouth like a fireplace, chimney for a nose, and railio dagger on his toes. Here some word meanings we will do. Spikes means thin pointed surface. Scales, thin bony plates protecting the skin of fish and reptiles. Underneath, situated directly below. Fireplace, an outdoor structure of brick, stone. Dagger, a sharp knife. The poet describes the dragon that it had big sharp teeth and spikes on top. This means that its skin was pointed on the top. On the lower part, it had scales which were bony plates of protect the skin. His mouth has been compared to a fireplace because it is assumed that dragon can release fire from the mouth. Even his nose is compared to a chimney which is used to pass out smoke. His feet are like sharp knife, that is a dagger. Now literary devices present in this stanza we will do. Rhyme scheme is AABB, teeth underneath, nose, toes, they are rhyming. Simile is used here. I have already told you what is simile. ड्रैगन्स माउथ इज कंपेयर्ड विथ फायर प्लेस. माउथ लाइक अ फायर प्लेस. रिफ्रेन रेपिटेशन ऑफ अ सेंटेंस अगेन एंड अगेन. एंड हेयर इन दिस पोएम द रेफ्रेन इज एंड्रीलियो ट्रीलियो. मेटाफर इज ऑल्सो यूज हेयर. डियर चिल्ड्रन मेटाफर इज अ फिगर ऑफ स्पीच वेयर कंपेरिजन इज मेड बट कंपेरेटिव वर्ड्स आर नॉट यूज. चिमनी फॉर अ नोज. द नोज इज लाइक अ चिमनी. सो मेटाफर इज देयर. Now, Stranger 4. Belinda was as brave as barrel full of bears. And Ink and Blink chased lions down the stairs. Mustard was as brave as a tiger in a rage. But Custard tried for a nice safe cage. Barrel meaning drum. Chased, hunt, follow. Rage means anger. So now the poet explains the inner strength or bravery of various characters of the poem. He says that Belinda was as brave as a group of bears, and Ink and Blink were so brave that they could hunt lions. So there he has shown the bravery of the kitten and the little mouse that could hunt even a lion. The dog was very brave, just like an angry tiger. But to contrast of all of them was Custard. Custard the dragon was not brave. He was so afraid of everything that he always demanded a safe cage. Now, literary devices present in this stranger. Rhyme scheme is always AABB is continuous. Simile. Belinda's bravery is compared to that of a barrel full of bears. Mustard's bravery is compared that of an angry tiger. So in both the cases, simile is used. Assonance is also used here. And dear children, what is assonance? Use of vowel sound. Belinda, A, as brave as barrel full of bears. So assonance is used. Now, Stranger 5. Belinda tickled him. She tickled him unmercifully. Ink, Blink and Mustard, they rudely called him Percival. They all sat laughing in the little red wagon at the railio trailio cowardly dragon. Tickled meaning stroke. Here it means to tease, unmerciful, cruel. Percival, a knight in the knight Arthur's court. This is the reference. Belinda used to stroke the dragon in a very cruel way. Ink, Blink and Mustard made fun of him by comparing him to a knight named Percival who was thought to be brave but ran away due to lack of courage. They used to tease the dragon while sitting in their little red wagon. Literary devices, rhyme scheme is again AABB. Refrain, repetition of a sentence again and again, that is, and a railio trailio, repetition. Use of word tickled him. Allusion, reference of any person or place. Here Percival reference has come, that is why use of allusion is made. Personification is also here used here. Ink, Blink and Mustard, they rudely called him Percival. So, Ink, Blink and Mustard are personified here. Now, Stranger 6. Belinda giggled till she shook the house and Blink said, "Weak," which is giggling for a mouse. Ink and Mustard rudely called his age when Custard tried for a nice safe cage. Giggled meaning to laugh. Weak, here it is the sound made by the mouse. The poet says that Belinda used to laugh so loudly that her voice echoed in the house. Blink the mouse used to laugh and make a sound of weak. On the other hand, Ink and Mustard would tease him by asking the dragon his age whenever he used to demand for a nice safe cage. Literary devices, rhyme scheme is as usual AABB. Onomatopoeia is used here. Onomatopoeia, where two opposite words are kept together. uses of onomatopoeia where sound is telling the meaning. Uses of sound words to create a dramatic effect. Giggled, weak. So onomatopoeia where sound is telling the meaning. Repetition, Custer tried for a nice safe cage. Thank you, dear students. I hope you have followed it.